The topic is finite state machine design steps. So what are the different steps that we are having in case of your SL? So here we are going, first we are having the problem statement. From problem statement, we are having the state diagram. From state diagram, we are going for reduced state diagram. Then we are going for state table, then excitation table, then flip-flop input equation and output equation, and finally we are going for circuit. The circuit, it is having the combinational and flip-flop. As you are knowing, the different kind of flip-flop will be there. So depending upon which flip-flop it is applicable here, we'll be going for that. If we are comparing these steps with the analysis of a sequential circuit, we will be seeing that these two steps earlier it was not there. We stopped here only. We stopped here only. So in case of your FSL design, this is most critical step. This is the most critical step. Means first you are having the problem. From that, how you are going for a state diagram? How you are going for making the state diagram? And if you are going for the state diagram, from there you need to go for reduced state diagram. Okay, so whatever state diagram is there, whether it is possible to reduce it further or not. So if you are going for reducing it, then you can go for your state table. From the state table, you will see that whether further it is possible to go for reducing it or not. If it is possible to reduce, then again you are going for state table. So these steps will be continuing like this. Okay. Then when you are having the state table, from that you can go for the excitation table, your flip-flop input, output equation, and then circuit. Now, for example, if you are seeing here you are having the finite state machine. You are having X as input, Z is your output. You are having the clock input. Okay. So let us say here we put some problem. So what is the problem statement here? Problem statement is you are having X as input, and what is this X? X is a sequence of bit, and those sequence of bit will be appearing in each clock pulse. So after every clock pulse, here you will be having some sequence of zeros and ones. Okay. And if you are seeing here, Z is your output. So what is the condition here? That your Z will be 1 when you will have a series of 1, 0, 1. So in this sequence, when you are getting 1, 0, 1, then Z as 1. So where you are having? At final here. So when you are having series 1, 0, 1, means at this one your Z will be 1. Otherwise your Z will be 0. So here I have taken an example. Here let your X be 1